Earl James.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the second match of the afternoon on the third day of the Stan James World Match Play Darts Championships. Please welcome former World Match Play Champion, the Eye of the Tiger, Peter Everson! And ladies and gentlemen, from Surrey, Diamond Dave Askew!
Well, neither of these players have been in top form of late, but Dave Askew often shines in front of the Sky TV cameras. Went well at the World Championships, of course, reached only the second round here in 2001. How will this one go? The Diamond against the Tiger. Let's join John Gwynn and Dave Lanning.
Will diamonds be forever, or will it be Tiger ragtime? That's the musical analogy for this match, and let's have a look at Everson's recent form on our screen crawler. It's now 16-32s, you see. He's always been sort of in the frame without any mega explosions on the graph, John Gwynn. And Diamond Dave, he tends to blow a little hot and cold as well.
Yes, capable of beating anybody, yeah. No question about it on his day. And Diamond Dave Askew has made two previous appearances here at Blackpool and hasn't been all that convincing. Saves his best performances for the Circus Tavern and the World Championships, it would seem, television-wise. But there's always got to be a first time. He's playing a man, of course, who 6 years ago to the week stole the show completely. It was Everson at his brilliant, brilliant best back in 1996. He even beat Phil Taylor 8-1 in the first round. That's how good Everson was playing. He hasn't played like that since. Some might say he hadn't played like that before, but he's a former world master as well. It's time that Everson showed his talent, and it's time that Askew took a liking to the Empress Ballroom, Blackpool. It's got the potential, therefore, for a cracker. It could also be a disappointing date. We'll see.
Yes, Everson has been a frustrating character because, as you rightly pointed out, John, he has got top-line talent. He's won big events. He was very, very close, indeed as close as anybody, to a televised nine-dart finish. And he's in this tournament, I recollect, doing two 170 checkouts. But that kind of form has only come in little brief glimpses. If it's consistency he's lacked.
Yes, they reckoned at one stage, the late 80s, early 90s, Everson destined for the top. And I suppose he could argue, what a great start to a game. Well, it wouldn't be the first time we've had a 180. I think it's the third time that I know of where a match has started with a maximum. And of course, in Mason's case, he followed up with another one.
Can ask you, that would set the revenge tingling if he could manage another 180. Yes, you were mentioning that Everson is overall 13th in the Blackpool
100.
This is his ninth world match play. He's averaged 29.64, whereas Askew is his third world match play. He's only won one and lost two of his matches, so he hasn't really hung around very long.
No.
In the shadow of the tower.
If we go on current rankings, Diamond Dave is ranked 11 and Everson 8 points behind him. We haven't had 8 places behind him, I should say. We haven't had too many occasions where the lower ranked player has beaten the higher ranked player. I think two.
100.
Well, Anderson did he not?
That's one of that I've got in mind. The other one was
Chris Mason, I think.
Steve Brown beating Dennis Smith. Of course, there is the Mason, yes, beating Burnett. You're right. That's three, Dave, yeah? But it, in the main, has gone the way of the man with the higher seed.
41. Dave, you require 101.
Ask you on 101 for the first leg with the throw.
69.
Got 69 to leave 32.
95. Dave, you require 32. Game shot at the first leg.
Compact job in the first leg from David Askew.
Second leg, Peter to Rupert.
When you have to win the match by at least two clear legs, and that is a fact, if it goes nine apiece, we hear that, and of course we remember that wonderful game last night.
105.
We hear that stated. I suppose it's important to have the throw if you feel that getting ahead is
45.
First and foremost what you want to do. But it isn't as big an advantage as it might be if you were playing set play. Because you've got to break the throw anyway of the other fella.
90.
Everson, see the way it quickly gains height like a jump jet.
140.
Everson, 22 gram nickel tungsten B&W darts, and John, it's an indication following the controversy with Harrington last night. I know
40.
That Everson has been working with his darts manufacturers. As you can see, he's losing some darts as well. He has been working overnight and this morning on his points on the dart just to try and alleviate the same kind of fallout trouble as we watch Askew hit 180. It's his second, but the fallout that Harrington has really caused some consternation and some thinking in the practice room. And look at Everson here. Going to square it up if he can.
139.
Well, a good reply to the maximum from Askew. Gives Askew a chance here to go two ahead and get an early break.
96.
And Everson really needs the Shanghai on 20s now to stay in touch.
100. Well, Askew has earned this first right to the right to the first shot at the double via the 180 earlier. That's the difference between the two in this leg. Now, double 10, double 5, this is where he can. Well, lose the benefit of getting down first.
Did the hard graft and handed the initiative back to Everson. Double 10.
He had a lovely dart there to use as a
game shot,
but it didn't matter. That's one leg all. A little bit of bounce in the step of Everson now.
Game to Roberts. Game on.
Yep, I like that, he said.
Impressive darts to start again from David Askew.
Well,
he's had one in each of three legs so far. Remarkable.
And it really was an astute piece of realignment there. The third dart, he just moved fractionally to get the geometry correct, which he did. 3-2-1. Now then, David. Another maximum to get things stirred.
What a pity. What a pity that one in the middle was a little bit overthrown, if you like.
He's playing crisply, clinically.
Well, a nice last start there. We saw it bisect the other two and find the treble 20. Now, what can Everson do?
11 dart possible kill from Askew, averaging 105, despite 60. Missing darts, three of them, at a double.
David required 81.
Oh, lovely dart. Double 12 then. Nice lie. Gotta fancy that. Look how he put that one right up against the one before it. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful. He'd had a lovely lie about it, that one. And a 12 darter to Askew. He's got an average of 104.16 at the moment. Admittedly, only three legs a dart, but he has hit three 180s. And in the second leg, Dave, he had three darts at a double, missed. That brought it down a bit. Had he hit that, he'd have been around about 109, 110.
And another one there, of course, in the last leg.
41. Yes.
Very close. Maurice Everson, you can see there's his release. And there's a lot of room in the treble for David Askew.
Oh, 140.
Everson here, getting a lot of support from Ireland. County Fermanagh, he said, remember me to the boys, and they'll remember shots like this.
140.
140, and a 140. Now, what can Askew do?
100. PD require 138.
Treble 18 will be a cracker here. Double 12 for a 138 checkout. Oh, dear, dear, dear.
It was a long way away.
Yes, it was the double 12. I think he had a shot at for the 9 darter, wasn't it, 12 months ago?
Double 18, I think, John.
140! PD required 24.
Yes, this time no problem. Two legs all, Peter even Everson. Contest. What a difference, though, in their averages. Askew 104.4, Everson 88.5. If that were to be maintained through the contest, then Askew would have to. You would see him break away. He would have to take throw off Everson. So far, it hasn't happened. He had one opportunity to do that second leg. And it looks as though it's going to be that kind of game where Askew's more likely to threaten Everson's throw than the other way round.
Taking his time to retrieve the darts, Everson. Can't believe this gamesmanship, but he does take a long time to get to the board and to move out of the way for Askew to throw. There is that exclusion zone, of course, but there is, I'm aware of, John, no time limit
100.
To go and get the darts.
100.
It's interesting thought, just watching Everson there. He's not in the exclusion zone at the rear, which was intended, but on the side there.
See how far he stands over 59. To the right of the hockey. Yeah. And I think Askew you'll find similarly. Harrington's another who throws right from well to the right of the hockey.
137.
Wherever he throws from, Rod Harrington, the
the darts weren't being very well behaved for him last night in the board. Had more fallers than the charge of the Light Brigade.
140.
Level 12 for 3-2 for Askew. Well, that's a very impressive opening set of darts from Dave Askew. He wins the first session 3-2, and he looks in very crisp form. Can Everson do anything to damp the diamond? We'll see in a moment or two.
Welcome back. You've just seen the best session by any player in this tournament so far. Dave Askew averaging 106.54, and when Phil Taylor won his second session against Shane Burgess, he averaged around 103, 104. Askew has superseded that, and yet for all that, Dave Lanning, Peter Everson is still in this match. He's got the throw in this second session. Effectively, 95. Things are all equal. That's the way it's gone. Every game with throw, and despite being superior in the scoring stakes, this is still a very close contest.
Yes, Everson probably in the break thought, well, I haven't done a bad old job here. 88 his average. This guy's averaging 106, and I've got the throw here in the second session. Interesting to hear Colin Lloyd's interview with our colleague Dave Clark there saying during the break how he went out back and talked to himself and to a blank wall and motivated himself. It might be interesting just maybe to have a camera on the boys from the break to see what they're saying to themselves.
Well, I had the pleasure of his company at breakfast, and he said today, he said, I'm never quite sure which head I'm going to have on. I know we apply that sometimes to Dennis Priestley, but it applies to all dart players. He said, if I can motivate myself and really get myself together, he said, that's okay. But sometimes it's difficult to do. It just ain't there. And obviously, he succeeded. Everson, 132. He's well ahead here, so doesn't need to go the ball route. 72 left. He may go treble 12, double 18. Well, he wanted fancy treble 20, double 106. But he's working there on the basis that he's well ahead. And why not? Playing in the comfort zone. Double 16 now, and it'll be three legs all.
PD required 32.
Man, you having said that, Dave, if Askew were to check out 158 now, it would be crucial. It would be pivotal in the match, I suspect.
Possibilities. Now they're treble 20 to leave, 38 double 19 would have hurt Everson. He's still got to get this double. Got to get it now, because Askew's resting on double 12. Big dart, this one important.
Game shot.
Oh, the relief, the relief. It was only when Bruce Bentley started chatting game shot that I'm convinced we knew. He did. He knew. He could see clearly from where he was. But 3-3.
Close call.
45.
Now then, a chance for the Fen Tiger to burn brightly.
What has happened here? Askew 102.45 and Everson 86.101. Is that when Askew has won his legs, he's won with comfort. When Everson's won his legs, that game apart, although Askew was on 24, he's tended to just sneak
45.
Well, it's don't know how you would him, John.
Yes. Oh, precisely. It won't matter to him one iota.
140. 100.
Oh, look at this, to leave 36. Well, 76, he'll be happy with that. He'd have settled for that at the start of the combination. And you see now, we're almost the reverse of the previous leg, where Everson dominated.
140.
David Askew looking 76. At 76. 16 for 40. Double top.
56.
Well, Everson unable to check on 176.
I must say, Dave, it's an observation you made a few minutes ago. Askew's much quicker away from
David
the board
Inquire
and back down
20.
The hockey than Everson is. Askew's waiting to throw, as you noticed. And but it doesn't bother him. He's quite happy to wait. That's a good dart. He worked inside to that.
Dave Askew.
Almost like a boxer there, seeking an opening for a body punch, wasn't it? He worked an opening. Not a rapturous start to the leg from Everson.
28.
There's room for a third. And that's David Askew, fourth 180 of this match. And you know, he's hit eight previously in two world match plays, so he's certainly displaying better Blackpool form at
41.
The moment. Again, it's the first three darts of a leg, too.
Yes, and for the first time since that second leg, where Askew broke away on Everson's throw but
85.
Failed to finish, we see a genuine opportunity of a breaking throw.
121.
Well, a loose last dart. And therefore, still a well and truly advantage Askew. Oh,
100.
What a lovely last start. See, the problem is with that loose dart, a 140 now leaves Everson on a 171. If only he could have found single 20 before he'd have been on the finish now. But there we are.
Might just be academic. 136 for Askew. 16 should be the shot.
96.
Would be the first time in the match that there's been a two-leg deficit if Askew can hit double top.
Well, and the reason is that it'll be the first break of throw in the match.
97.
Tops there for a 5-3 advantage. Throwing first next leg. Real daylight between himself and his opponent. If he can find the double, which he does. So Everson threw first, but Askew threw last. And that's the most important dart of the lot, the last one.
Rover.
That was the winning throw there. Double 10, David Askew with the dart. Start of the ninth. Beautiful first dart. Equally attractive second dart.
140.
Still, it sets a blistering pace for the Tiger.
100.
Might have been a bit disappointed after that first dart not to have hit at least one more treble, Dave. It was beautifully positioned, inviting another one to join it. That's not a bad one either.
100.
Still averaging over 100. 102, Dave Askew, and we're down, the ninth leg?
I actually think that his average has never actually dipped below three figures. He started
100.
The match with a 180. It's wonderful effort, really, from Askew. That is consistency. We are now in the ninth leg of the match, and he's developed a real consistency here.
Yeah, I seem to remember him doing this in another tournament. John, you'll recall probably which one it was.
It was Purfleet World Championship.
Stunning.
Not the 2002 one, just gone, well, back in January. The 2001 46. World Championships. He averaged a staggering 107 in one game, I recall.
25 would leave 36, double 18.
135.
Still went for the 45. Still has left himself an eminently attainable check eight.
100. David Aguirre, 46.
Now then, double 16. Oh, he's not missing those, is he? Three legs on the trot. Absolutely imperative here for Everson that he wins this leg. He's throwing first. He's got to hold his throw. Otherwise, he'll go into the second break. Four legs adrift.
Well, if Askew could plant a maximum here, it really would set him up, and he might just have got the message.
140.
Well, Everson starts with a ton. Askew follows up with a 140.
140. I think he was aiming at the treble 18, then 44. The treble 19, and not getting much hunting.
And already Askew with the throw, only four behind. Effectively now with the throw, although he's got to get a treble here to 60. Maintain it.
Shielding a lot of the target.
60. The
first two darts. Well,
125.
Last dart took a deflection. See it there. Oh,
mighty deflection, wasn't it?
Half an inch maybe.
100.
Still Askew has gained the throw.
55.
To leave 1-2-1, so Everson needs, I would suspect here, a ton, 140. You would fancy Askew to get 1-2-1 in six darts, even in three possibly. So Everson really here has got to get right down.
83.
Not enough.
David Aguirre, 121
for Askew, and a commanding lead. 11 would leave the ball. Having a good look at it, yes, he knows Everson could finish on 114. 11 for the ball. Such an important dart, and just
96.
At 2 o'clock, too high.
PD require 114.
So, got to put in a throw here. Now, it's gone from Everson in the last couple of legs. It's gone. It's a good recovery, but it's probably too late.
25 for a really commanding lead. Double eight. He has two darts. And he needs the one. And David Askew really had a diamond session there. Winning four legs on the spin. And the diamond is really shining brightly. And the Fen Tiger has his tail between his legs.
Inevitably, Askew, maintaining a three-figure average, was going to break away sooner or later. It's happened. He's won four legs in a row. He deserves to be ahead seven legs to three. And Everson has a mighty task. It was all so even at the start of the last session. Now, Not so. In fact, Everson made it 3-3 with the first leg of that last session. Since then, he hasn't taken a leg. I'd be very interested, Dave, to see what the actual finishes are, because the I think Everson's put some terrific legs together. Sure, he's had an 11, a 13 and a 14.
It's been a muscular performance from David Askew. The diamond has been shining and sparkling. Diamond performance that even Joan Collins in town recently, 60. She opened a burlesque club called Funny Girls, would have acknowledged. Forty in front, Askew. Oof, that's a rare slack throw.
41.
100. Ton for Everson, finding that treble 20 at last. He looks still fairly composed. To what extent he believes he can get back in this match, I don't know, but we've seen Colin Lloyd already today come back from a similar sort of position. I think he was 7-4 down, wasn't he, and ended up winning 10-7. Alan Moriner yesterday came back against Les Fitton in these kind of circumstances.
45.
But there's no sign of Askew relenting, Dave. He's just hit a 41, but that's the one poor throw that he's allowed, let's be honest. Any player's allowed from time to time.
Yes, it takes him out of three-figure average for the first time as well. Just that is the cruelty of big-time darts.
100. Dave, you require
100. Two darts away from a 8-3 advantage. Oh, it's a bad dart. Can't finish now.
68.
I believe 32.
But Everson has got to take this kind of chance if he is to prevail. 76. Double top. It's an audacious attempt.
76.
It really was a bold move there from Everson, and I'm sure he meant what he was doing.
32. Now then, double eight then. And that's an awkward one. Got a... just come inside, not for him, it isn't. Oh, a bit of emotion from Askew. 8-3.
12th play, Peter to throw first.
Well, now then, Everson would have to achieve a remarkable comeback now. 8-3 down, and Askew with 59. A dance in the 13th leg and the 15th.
41.
Oh, that's another 41. Just there you are. There's a 12, a 13, and two 14s. That was when he's really going well, and he hit three 180s in the first session, one in the second, not one yet in this. He's up 241, so his average has gone down to 96. But that's still represents a really good performance.
But he's still got to finish 100. It off. Because, as you were saying, John, at this stage in the last match, that Mick Manning would have been quite happy with his performance. And yet, the bottom fell out of his entire world.
100!
Well, you see the quite wonderfully produced programme that... once again is available to spectators, and they like to get those pictures and those pen files signed up by the players, and
very rarely
they all oblige.
Very rarely you see a dart player who isn't prepared to get them in a queue and sign the lot.
85.
Everton has got to pick up the scraps here. Can't afford really to lose another leg.
64.
also on offer, you know, to spectators. Dartboards, these boards that we see in use, signed on the back in marker by the players, and they can
charge
quite useful sums at auction and charity functions. Raffles.
And I know one man who would say that's the best use for them too.
Seventy-three.
Wanted 14s there, but Askew, treble 17, leaves double 12. 18 for tops. For 9-3, one leg away from victory.
55.
Let off.
Pin, you require 41.
41. Goodness me, he's missing left, right and centre now.
31.
Well, that was an impressive effort,
20.
And has let Askew look at double 10 with great confidence.
Yeah, I think it's game over now. And I'm not trying to be clever when I say that, obviously, because he only wants one more, but I'm saying that on the basis of real waywardness from Everson in the last few legs. He's thrown far too many stray darts. I know I said that yesterday when Anderson was playing, but this is an even bigger mountain than he had to climb, isn't it? 9-3.
Yes, Bob was at 9-6. Big difference.
140.
Wonderfully respectful audience, and
the kind of lovely Blackpool holidaymakers you expect 100. To see in the Tower Ballroom with the old time dancing, but.
I think they were on the way to the Waterloo and the bowls, and they said, no, we'll call in at the darts instead.
46.
Does have such a confident air about himself, Askew, when he's on his game. He looks the goods, and Everson looking at 180, that's the first he's had. That's his 49th here in Blackpool over the years.
And there may not be time for him to get a 50th. He's got to get one now, 60. Dave, if he is.
Pitching
so, well,
135.
He can't, can he? He's on 135, of course. Now he's. He doesn't need to go the bull route with Askew being back on 181. So
95.
15 will leave him with tops. Askew can't check out here.
60. Peter, you require 40. Game shot in the 13th leg. Peter Everson.
Nobody has yet finished on anything as high as 40, would you believe, Dave?
Peter to throw.
Amazing, isn't it?
Game on.
Everson did have a dart at double 12 for a 138. He missed that, but there haven't been any big checkouts.
Well, he said,
amazing, really.
He said 21 checkouts in excess of 100 over 100. The years, including, I recall, those two 170s 1 year. But now. Askew must just keep chipping away and just wait for his moment.
140.
Well, he hasn't been as convincing in this session, Askew. His average has gone down to 94.19. He's thrown well for two sessions, really, really well. And I would suggest that when you're playing, with great respect to Everson, superior players such as Taylor, you really got to maintain that three-figure over a longer period.
85.
Askew has definitely shown on so many occasions that he's got what it takes to really put in the kind of performance to shake the best. It's maintaining it over the longer distance. Yes, he's a bit warm.
95.
And Everson clearly doesn't think this match is over.
PD require 81.
Will leave tops.
61.
Yes, so Askew will go the ball route. He will go 25-20 ball if he hits the 50. Oh, it's a long way off, so that's 85 left. 70 left, he'll go treble 18. Missed it, 67 left. Chance for Heavyston to make it 9-5. Mind you, he did throw 20. First in this leg. 77. That's another careless dart. That might be his last. So Askew, treble 17 for double 8.
67.
And even if he's single 17, it'll be 50 left. He'll probably go 18, double 16. Double 8 then for the match here for Diamond Dave Askew and a place in round 2. Yes, it's a gem of a dart and a gem of a performance. Askew sailing through a competitive first session. Askew led 3-2 at the first break, but had a marvellous 106.54 average. He still had 100 average at the end of the second session. He's finished with an average of around about 93. A very, very decent performance. A little disappointing, Everson there. It's Askew in round 2.